Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So this channel, Everyday Data Science, is all about trying to learn the different concepts involved in data science by practicing a lot of questions. In this video, I am going to solve this question on LeetCode regarding rearranging products table and try to walk you through how we can develop solutions to such problems. This question has been asked in Amazon interviews over the past couple of years. Okay, so let's jump right in. We are given a table called products with four different columns: product ID, store 1, store 2, store 3, and all of them have data type integer. Product ID is the primary key for this table, and each row of this table indicates the product's price in three different stores: store 1, 2, and 3. If the product is not available, then the price is null in that store's column. We are asked to write a SQL query to rearrange the products table so that each row has product ID, store, and price. If a product is not available in the store, do not include a row with that product ID and store combination in the result table, and the order of the result does not matter. Basically, what the question is saying is we need to convert the columns into rows. So you might have heard, so there is a concept called pivot, right? So pivot is basically converting rows into columns. And here we are asked to do the reverse of it, right? We need to convert columns. So these three columns, we need to convert it into rows. So if you see, basically, if this is the input table, there are two products and these are their prices in the three different stores. We basically need to create a table which has three columns: product ID, the store, and like which store, and the price in that particular store. So for example, the first row would be product ID 0 in store 1, the price is 95. Product ID 0 in store 2, the price is 100. Product ID 0 in store 3, the price is 105. And since it is mentioned, we do not have to include a row where product ID and store combination does not has any price. So basically what it means is, like, for example, this, right? Product ID 1 in store 2 has null value. So this means basically that product is not present in store 2. So we do not need to include that in our output. So if you see here, you won't find any product ID 1 in store 2. Product ID 1 only has store 1 and store 3. So this is what we need to do. So also another thing, pivot is a function that we can perform in MySQL, but there is another function called unpivot. But unpivot is a function of MS SQL, not MySQL. So remember that if you try to, you know, use unpivot function in MySQL, you won't be able to do this question. So one way to do this question is to use union. So basically it is just a union of three different queries, and like all those three queries are basically similar. So let me tell you what I mean. So if we take from this table called products, right, if we from this table here, if we take only those rows where the value or where basically the price is not null in one particular store. So let's start with store 1, right? So from this table products, where store 1 is not null, right? So basically these are the columns and these are the prices, right? So basically store 1 is not null. So basically the price in that in store 1 is not null. So if you look at this input table, so here, since in both the rows the store 1 has some value which is not null, so both these rows will be included. And from this, if we return, what do we need to return? The product ID, store, a column called store which says which store the product belongs to, and the price, right? So basically we need to return three different columns. So if you return the first one, product ID, right? And now since we are only here talking about store 1, right? So where store 1 is not null, so we can enter a string store one and name it as store. So the name of the column is store, where we are entering the string store one. So remember, this store one and this store one is different, right? So this is the name of the column from the products table. Here we are entering, or basically here we are creating a new column called store, where we are entering a string called store one, right? So store one, and the third column would be the price, right? So basically the price is coming from this particular column, right? So store one as price. So basically what will this do, right? So let me just, because the other part of the query is just, you know, doing the same thing two more times and then making a union, right? But let me show you what this specific query will do. So it will create three columns, right? Product ID, another column would be store, another column would be price. Okay, so from this table where store one is not null, so it will take both these rows. Then what it will do, okay, so product ID zero, right? So product ID zero, and then in the store column it will enter the string store one. And then in the price is coming from store one column, right? So product ID zero, store one has the price 95, right? So 95. Then this row is done, right? Since we are only looking at this column, right? So here we are like, we do not care about these two in this particular query. So now the cursor will go to row two, right? So row two, product ID is one. In the store column, since for every row it needs to enter store one string in the store column, so it will again enter store one, and the price will come from here. So this is 70, right? So 70, and now it's done. 0 and 1. So basically, if you see 0 store 1 95, 1 store 1 70. So these two rows are present. If we do the same thing with store 2 and store 3 and make a union, so basically what does union do? It stacks rows over one another, right? So this is from this one, right? So if we take this one, copy this, and instead of store one, we do store two here, we do store two here, and rest everything will remain same. So in that case, what will happen, right? So now in that case, what is the output going to be? So again, product ID zero, store in the store column, it is going to insert the string store two, the price is going to be 0 store 200, right? Now since here we are only taking from products where store 2 is not null, right? So here this is null, so only this row will be there, row 1 will be, you know, won't be included, right? And then finally the third time, copy this and make this store 3, make this store 3, right? So now what will this do? Copy, you can write it with me or you can say it with me. So again, product ID 0, product ID 1, in the store column it will insert what? Store 3. It will insert store 3, and in the price column it will insert, so 0 105, right? So 105 for 1 store 3 AD, right? AD. So if you see two rows, 1, 3 and 2, 5. So here in the output, you see these are the same rows, five rows, right? So basically all you need to do is union these three results, right? So what do? You, after this, insert keyword called union. From here again, after this you insert union. So this will basically, what it will do, it will take this, add here, it will take this and add here, and that is your output, right? Let me remove this. And this is your output, right? This is your output. If you see, this is the exact same thing. So let me remove this. This looks good. And this is how we can solve this. Let me go ahead and run this code to see what happens. Okay, so do you understand why there was a wrong answer error? There is one small mistake that I have done here. Can you guess it? Yeah, so if you guessed it, so actually when I was copying pasting here, even though I am writing store2 is not null and entering store2, but here I am taking the values from store1 as only, right? So that is the error that I did. So here if I just change this to store2, store3, and that's it, right? Now let me go ahead and run this. So yeah, if you see, this is accepted. Let me go ahead and submit it and see if it passes all the test cases. So yeah, this passes all the test cases, and this is how we do it. Again, remember, even if you are writing a very simple query, if you copy paste, try to focus that, you know, you are not, or basically you are changing the code at every place that you need to. And this is an example of how we can do unpivot in MySQL. If you use MS SQL and you know how we can write the same query using unpivot function, comment down below. And yeah, so this is how we solve this question, and I will see you guys in the next video.